There is nothing as annoying as having a soft log drum, except if that is what you are going for. But if that is not what you are going for, but you don't just have it cutting through your mix, like you can't get the boom, boom, boom out of your log drum, I'm going to show you how to take your log drum from this. You see? Let's turn it on to this. Or this. Yes, so that is what we'll be doing today. So if that interests you, stick around after the intro. Wire! Welcome to World Wave Radio, where we bring the word to you. So yes, just to let you know that the Chris Beat Music Academy has started. So click the link below to join, sign up for the class, whether in the intermediate, the recording mixing class, beats making class, advanced beat making class, if you will. Advanced is where you get to do all of the things put together. So yes, with that out of the way, there are three major ways to mix a log drum. You know, allowing it to cut through your mix, being able to get the best sound that you want, you know. And you first of all need to know that log drum is not an 808, so it would be wrong for you to approach your log drum the same way you approach 808. It's not an 808, so don't treat it as such. It is better treated like a talking drum. So if you don't know what a talking drum is, you can treat your log drum the same way you treat your talking drum, the same way you shape it. You know, talking drum is not what you hide in a mix. Talking drum is something that shines through, except if it's a type of song that you are going for. Talking drum, like we said, talking drum. So log drum is a type of talking drum, not an 808. So I'm going to be showing you three ways to get it to sound right, and the third one is my absolute favorite. So I like to target beginner, intermediate, and advanced. So yeah, the third one is my absolute favorite, but any which one can be used. I use any of them. Another important thing to point out is the log drum will be entirely based on the type of sample that the log drum is. You know, is it a log drum that will cut through, or is it a soft clip log drum, or is it a hard clip log? We determine the type of character that you want to go for. But whatever log drum it is, the same rule will still apply to it. It's just the approach might just be different as to how subtle or how hard it is. So with that said, the first way is the beginner approach, which is to get a very good log drum that is already mixed. So you see good log drums from a place like Splice, from Loopmaster, and all those places that we get samples from. You can see it well, you know, the tone is balanced, they already have things mixed into it. So you can use that, and it takes you time to select the actual type of log drum that you want. If you get a log drum that is cool, you don't have a lot going on character wise you know, it's very cool just for tone shaping, you can use that to get to where you want to go. And if you are like me and you don't have the time to select samples as you go, because when I'm making beats, I don't want to be thinking of, oh, I need this sample, I just want to get anything I can to get and shape that thing into what I want, then move on, you know, as opposed to, you know, the click, forever clicking that music producers do, especially when they are making beats, looking for right log drum, looking for right snares. You don't want to be caught in that trap. Number two is called malting. This is kind of like an intermediate approach where you duplicate two or three bands of the same instrument, and then you create what we call malting in audio technology. So you can duplicate different band of the same frequency, and then you can process them differently. Here we have the low. Then we have the mid here. Then we have the high here. So now you can decide to go as crazy as you want to go on any of these ones without affecting the whole thing. Let's say on this, I can say, okay, maybe it's the mid that is the most important thing. I can put a compressor and squash the mid.
You hear the difference now. Let's hear it in the context of the beat. You get, you can use this. You can also put a saturator on that. Yeah. You can decide to mess around with it. You can remove all this same thing from the mid and put it on the high so that when people are bumping on the phone, they get the same vibe that you want them to get. Yes, so moving on. The last one is my absolute favorite, and you can use this with anyone because it uses one of my favorite things to use. So I use the clipper here, but I'm not using the clipper, but the major thing here I'm using is Saturn. So this is kind of like what we're doing with Molten, but this is beautiful because it gives you different types of way that you can saturate the frequency that you want to saturate. So with this, we can add different flavors of saturation that we want. So in the high, I have a gentle saturation. In the mid, I have heavy saturation. Then I have a little warm saturation in the last part. Of course, gain staging is the most important thing. As you are adding, you are taking out. As you are adding, you are taking out from this side. So let's see what this one sounds like. You can see the dirtiness. You can hear the grittiness. Let me play it alone. Let me turn it off so you hear where we're coming from. You see? Let's turn it on. And you can even try it right here, right now. If you are listening or if you are not listening on your phone, try to listen on your phone to see how it sounds. You'll be able to hear every nuance of the log drum. So that is exactly how you get your log drum to punch through no matter where you are playing it from. Different ways. I could have done this with this Molten just by seeing which frequency allows me to get things out. Some people might prefer this Molten because it allows them to also dial an EQ to the saturator. So that's if you don't have this Saturn. But if you have Saturn, is one of the best ways to do it because I can even go in here and select, let's say, and select the type of saturation. Let's change this from heavy saturation to gentle transformer. You see? We don't get that gun anymore. Let me get the heavy saturation. Yes, there you go. Let's go again. Let's go again. Again. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, so let's listen to the beat from the beginning and how we, not from the beginning, but let's listen to how we get into that plan. Thank you. Yes, there you have it. This is one of the quick little tutorials I promised that we will start doing. So yes, I brought it your way once again. Like, subscribe if you find any of this thing interesting. And yes, feel free to join us at Chris Beat Music Academy. Book a call, chat them. Let us know how we, you know, can help you elevate your music to the next level. And I will catch you in the next class. Love.